Today, we'll focus on a few more commonly used meeting and security settings. From your Zoom web portal, navigate to the primary menu on the left and click Settings. Let's start with a selection of powerful security options, waiting rooms, and meeting passcode requirements. When toggled on, all of your participants will be placed in a virtual waiting room until you let them in. This way, you can ensure those trying to get into the meeting are invited guests. Turning on the meeting passcode setting will generate and require a passcode for your meetings. Moving on to a few popular meeting scheduling options. Under audio type, you can choose if you'd like to allow participants to use their computer's audio, telephone, or both. It's important to select both if you think some of your users will be dialing in to connect to telephone audio. Another scheduling setting to consider is mute all participants.
So the other day at the grocery store, right?
Excuse me, could you mute please? Anyway, mute all participants when they join a meeting. Participants can unmute themselves during the meeting, but this setting ensures they don't accidentally disrupt the speaker or host when they join. Next on our settings list are basic in-meeting options. Because there are many to choose from, we'll lump a few of them into larger categories. First are several in-meeting chat options. You can allow users to type chats to the group or just to some users while in a meeting or webinar, among other choices. We can loosely call the next grouping interactions. You can add polls and quizzes, allow screen sharing, annotating, and whiteboarding. You'll also find some participant-related settings here, like nonverbal feedback and emoji reaction options, renaming permissions, and more. Finally, we'll move to the advanced in-meeting options. Like the other settings we've covered, there's a lot you can do here, so we'll highlight just a few. First, when enabled, breakout rooms allow the host to split participants into separate, smaller rooms. It's a really great feature to try out when you're feeling ready. Another important feature to point out here is closed captioning. You can enable use of a third-party generated captioning service, typed captions, or even free automatic closed captions, also known as live transcription. A bit below this is a group of settings related to video and layouts: virtual backgrounds, video filters, immersive views, focus mode, and even virtual avatars. These are a lot of fun, so be sure to enable them here and try them out. A final important setting is Report to Zoom, which allows users to report meeting participants for inappropriate behavior to Zoom's Trust and Safety team for review. Zoom is committed to maintaining an equal, respectful, and inclusive environment on and through our platform for all users. We've just reviewed some of Zoom's popular setting options. You're encouraged to head over to your own web portal to explore these and some of the many others available to you, like recording settings, Zoom app settings, and more. Thanks for watching, and meet happy.